I ask you to help me to forgive all those who have sexually abused me. I command every hidden of sexual abuse to come out of me now in the name of the Lord Jesus. I cast out of me any spirits of fear of love, inability to give or receive love, abuse by my father, mother, brother, sister, in-laws, aunts, uncles, friends, boyfriends, girlfriends, neighbors, trusted friends, or any other spirits of abuse that I may not remember. Lord, I cast out of spirits of blocked sex. Oh, let me do that. Let me just say that so y'all don't have to. I'm going to do this. I come against spirits of blocked sex, blocked orgasms, hatred of sex, hatred of men and women, rape spirits, ruler of rape, spirits in me that draw rape spirits toward me, self-hatred, ugly spirits, addiction spirits because of sexual abuse, hurt, deep hurt, incest spirits, demonic desire for a family member, suicide spirits from being raped, insanity spirits from being molested, no trust, bound trust, fear of trusting, torment spirits from abuse. I command destruction spirits from being hurt, destruction in me, destruction anybody that tries to love me, control spirits due to being raped, Jezebel spirits that enter in as a defense against any man ever hurting me again, hatred of women, spirits that came in from being raped, incest, sexual abuse, fear of children being attacked in the same way, murder spirits toward one who used me, come out in the name of Jesus Christ. I forgot about that other spirit. Especially in women, if they've been molested, later on in life when they get married, they have a problem trusting their husband with their female kids. That's a spirit. You need to get that thing out. Amen? Let's go on. Now, if you've ever been molested or raped, you got to forgive the person. You were violated. You should be angry about it. Mistrust came in, you still have to forgive them. It's okay to be angry, but don't sin. You have to release them and let God deal with them. The Bible says about children, it would be better that they put a millstone around their neck and be cast in the sea than to touch one of those little children. Judgment day is going to come. You release them, it releases you. God will deal with them. Amen? So don't hold unforgiveness into somebody that you need to. And nowadays, you got to be careful, even with pastors. Amen. It's a shame what some of these pastors are doing. It's crazy. Listen, I'm telling every daughter in there, you watch these kids in here. Everybody come in the door, they may be saved, but they still may have some spirits in them. Amen. Won't leave you alone with them. Amen. Don't leave you alone with the children. We try to have. Even if you had couples working with the children, you got to make sure the couples are, you know, their character and stuff. They've been through deliverance. Got them devils out. Amen? We don't want nobody unclean messing with our children. Amen? Go to 1 Corinthians chapter 6, I believe it is. Verse 9 says, know you not that the unrighteous shall not inherit the kingdom of God? Be not deceived. Neither fornicators. Fornicators are those that have sex without being married. That's what a fornicator is. Having sex, not being married. That's what fornicator. You ain't going in the kingdom. Nor idolaters, nor adulterers, nor effeminate. Remember what effeminate is? Homosexual. Nor abusers of themselves with mankind. Even if you abuse yourself. So all this abuse that you do, the idolatry. What did the prophets of Baal do when Elijah challenged them? They begin to cut themselves. They begin to cut themselves and mar themselves and bleed. There are children that cut themselves because they've been molested. They're always cutting. Suffering, cutting. As I said, I had prepared my message. I did the thing at the juvenile detention center here in Kane County. I believe it was 200 and from March of 2008 to January of 2010, there were 217 cases of ADHD, 220 cases of AD, 100-something cases of manic depressive. These are kids, manic depressive, violent response, 125. I mean, it added up. There's a lot of kids going through a lot of stuff. And they're putting them on Ritalin, and they're putting them on drugs. All it is doing is masking over what these spirits are doing. Some of these children are alive and strong, and Ritalin ain't the thing. Even if the child is born, and if you're born conceived in alcohol, if your parents weren't married, or they conceive you, or your father was drunk, or your mother was drunk, the spirit of alcohol comes through the bloodline. It is in the child because you were conceived in alcohol. I know, but I had to get delivered. I dealt with alcohol. It was in my bloodline, and I had to get filled with that alcohol spirit. Conceived in lust. If you had a child if your mother had a child when she was 14, that spirit will come, illegitimacy will come, and you'll have a child when you're 14. And then your child will have a child when they're 14 or 15 or 16, whatever, if you don't break that curse. That's a curse. Amen. The child is not illegitimate. The act is illegitimate. Amen. All children are from the Lord, but the act is illegitimate. You're not born a homosexual. You're born with a spirit that attacks you that came through the bloodline. Amen. It depends on how your parents were when you got. If you were untimely, a surprise, and they tried to abort you, spirits enter into your life. And then all your life you feel rejected and abandoned. And you can't understand. And your mama loving you and hugging you. And you can't. Why is this child like this? Well, your emotional state. That thing entered in through that emotional state. I think I shared with you that Apostle Cord Wade, when we were in Chicago, everybody was prophesying that they were going to have a boy, and then when the baby came, it was a girl. That was before they started telling when it was. And that child clung to him all the time. He couldn't understand why that child was so clingy, just hanging on, and just they loved her and nurtured her, but she just couldn't. You know, you just couldn't get loose from that thing, and they found out it was a spirit of design. They were looking for a boy, and a girl came out, and she felt so rejected. The spirit of deep rejection was on that child when it was born because the parents, while she was in the womb, parents were looking for a boy. They weren't prepared for her. And so the devil is insidious. He is wicked. He takes advantage of the. Then there are children who are born through occult sex, or called breeders. Satanists use them to breed them. I won't even get into that realm. There's a whole teaching I did on that satanic sexual abuse. Actually, brainwashed women that have been molested and abused at a young age as kids, raised them to have babies that they would sacrifice these babies on altars. Or have sex with these babies and kill them. What's going on in America? They're snatching kids. Go to Walmart. Have you seen this child? That child is in some sleazy hotel being molested or used as a prostitute. They're trafficking, slavery. They're doing all of this now. You got to be aware of what's going on. Don't be walking around there with your head in the cloud. Oh, I like this boy. That boy will slap you upside your head if he gets a chance. Amen. That's why I say he that finds a wife. If you're not looking for a wife, you don't need to be dating. You ain't ready. You're not ready. Your body says you're ready. And you can have kids, but the maturity is not there. The money ain't there. Come on, when you have babies, what are you going to do? I'm going to take them home to mama. Mama and them are going to take care. Grandmama and them trying to retire. And grandmama and them got your kids. Amen. Because grandmama don't want to see them kids destroyed because you out there acting stupid. Let's tell the truth. She ain't the devil. I say this all the time, and especially you Christian girls. But some way, some kind of way, the devil tells you that because you're a Christian, if you have sex, you ain't going to get pregnant. Like you're immune to it. Like you got a holy anointing that makes you immune to being pregnant. I tell you the truth, you'll be fat. Amen. You can't cover it up. You can't push it back up in it because it's coming out. Amen. It will grow. Let's go on to, I want to deal a little bit with the other side of a